Jonathan here with Candy, Kansas Fishing. Well, Greg from Tackle Factory, he sent me these minnow trap stuff, and one thing I thought was really cool was this, like, I think it's called like the Easy Snap or something like that, and it's really cool. Like, instead of having to undo your clip, you can, like, the trap just opens up. Sorry, I'm trying to do this one-handed, it's kind of hard. But, like, it opens up like that, and then it won't come undone while it's in the pond or anything, because it's got this nice long spring on there. And then I got a minnow trap extender, and then I got an extra funnel, because on my other minnow trap that I have, one of the funnels is broken. And then I have two of these, like, half cap things. And then I also got like a lid, so you could like put it on one of these end caps and have a minnow cage that goes underwater. And then this one's a floating minnow cage, and it's really cool, because then you can just open it and put your minnows in there. And yeah, and then they also sent me a minnow net and a fish scaler. So I just want to say thank you to Greg, because I just love how they do that. Like, they do this stuff for all these YouTube channels and stuff, and people who don't have like 100,000 subscribers. And I think they do a great job at like just showing their product and stuff. And I think they just do a great job at that. So I'll show you guys this stuff in action here in a second. All right, bye. Guys, I just wanted to show you how this easy quick latch thing worked. I forget what it's called, but I caught some fish in my other minnow trap over there, and then I'll just show you how this works. It's gonna be a little tough because I'm trying to do this one-handed, but you can just open it up like that and dump your fish in. That's it. And then, well, this thing is the floating bait holder, so you can come out here and then just throw your thing in there, and you can keep them in here for a long time because you don't have to aerate the water and they'll have food and stuff. So yeah. So, and then I'll put some videos at the end of this video, some little clips of some stuff that's happened over the past couple of weeks, because I haven't made a video in like 3 weeks, and just, well, some stuff's happened, but it hasn't really been that eventful. So, and there's just been a lot of stuff going on, so I couldn't make any videos. So, all right, talk to you guys later. Hey guys, I just wanted to show you everything like assembled and stuff. So here's the minnow traps with the extenders on it, and well, the extender, and it's pretty cool. And then here's like a minnow cage that you can just throw in the water, and then there's the floating one. And well, Greg, he's just so nice. He even like took it time out of his day to like write a letter to me and gave me several calls and stuff. And I just recommend these traps because they're amazing people there, and they're so nice. You just need to go out and get you one of these G's minnow traps, and they're really high quality too. So all right, see you guys later. Hey guys, Ethan here with Caney Cans Fishing. Well, I just shot a dove, and then, well, he was clear over there, and then he was still alive when he was coming down. Then he flew right into this rat's nest and crawled down into a tunnel. Now, I've been digging this whole thing out. This part was as tall as that, but I've been digging it out, and I keep finding feathers and blood and stuff. And then my dog can smell him, so he's definitely down here, but yeah. Guys, I'm back about 5 minutes later, maybe 10 minutes later, I'm not sure. But I got him down here. Oh, wow. Boys, definitely my dove because he's still warm, so. But that's crazy though, I've never had a dove do that. And I just think that's hilarious how he flew into this. So I just caught this live sparrow. He's like injured or something and he's not looking too healthy. He can kind of fly, but he's gonna get eaten by a cat or something, so I'm just gonna have to put him down. But last night, my dad had a fire, and right when we were leaving from the football game, we had to turn right back around, so I had to stay there till 1 in the morning, and it's 11 right now, but I'm still really tired, so, yeah.